Well, we've seen several videos of farmers throwing away their hard-grown produce for want of pricing. Farmers have been facing a lot of distress. And on Mirror Now, we have been highlighting all of the farmer distress and all the farmer protests that have been happening. And one of the reasons now that are really troubling farmers as far as Maharashtra is concerned is plunging onion prices. And to find out more about why these farmers get only a fraction of the cost that you and I pay for onions, our reporter Disha went on ground and tracked the entire journey of both onions and tomatoes from the farmer to the retailer from whom you and I buy our vegetables. And this is what she found. Take a look at the special report.
आप प्याज और टमाटर एक किलो ग्राहक को कितने में बेचते हैं?
टमाटर 20 रुपए किलो, प्याज 30 रुपए किलो.
So if you and I pay 20 and 30 rupees per kilo for onions and tomatoes, have you ever wondered what a farmer really gets for this produce? To find an answer to this, we travel 250 kilometers away from Mumbai to trace the journey of onions and tomatoes. The journey which tries to establish what really happens between the farm and the fork.
We visited an onion and spinach farm in Shevade village in Pune. At 5 in the evening, farmers had already started the process of plucking their produce. Bags were filled and loaded onto vehicles to take them to Pune's largest wholesaler market, the APMC. The next leg of a journey that began 4.5 months ago.
Now all of this is being taken by the middleman, by the transportation agent to the APMC market in Pune. And what the farmers here tell us is the fact that they will take approximately about 1 a.m. to reach the market, and only after that they'll be able to get the price.
Here, farmers cannot sell directly to the consumers. The onion and tomatoes are handled by multiple people, with the farmer forking out more money in market fees, laborer fees, and a fee for weighing their product.
It's 1 a.m. and here we are at the APMC market in Pune. And as you can see behind me, slowly the vehicles have started arriving here at the APMC market. Till about 12 a.m., almost 60 vehicles have arrived.
Only about 10% of people here were farmers, the rest middlemen or agents. Expectations of farmers like Bharat from Ahmednagar, who brought 4,500 kgs of onions, have been hit badly by plunging prices over the last 6 months.
7 rupees, 8 rupees, 10 rupees tak. Lekin abhi to mandi hai. Market mein uttam bazaar nahi mil raha hai. 10 rupees tak milega to bhi acha rahega isse.
हमारा जो प्याज का इतने दिनों तक हमने जो रखा है उसका तो कुछ निकल ही नहीं रहा अभी इसमें, लेकिन उधर हमारे लासलगांव मंडी में तो कम से अभी 1.5 से 3 रुपए बेच रहे, इसलिए हम इतनी दूर इधर आए, लेकिन इधर भी अच्छा रेट नहीं मिल रहा है। इस रेट से हमको कुछ मिलता तो कुछ नहीं, लेकिन वैसे अभी फेंक देने से तो कुछ नहीं मिलेगा, इसलिए कुछ ना कुछ मिलेगा इस आशा से हम इतनी दूर तक आए।
3:30 a.m. a silent auction between a trader and a wholesaler takes place. It's the trader and not the farmer that decides at what rate the produce will be sold. And the farmer only finds out what price his product has gone for hours later.
The trader here is unloading the produce from this vehicle and loading to the purchaser's vehicle. As you can see here, the trader decides at what price the produce should be sold per kilo. But the biggest rider here is the fact that the wholesaler doesn't know what is the price. Even the farmer who is at the receiving end doesn't know what the price is.
In
most of the cases, there isn't even an auction. Rates are fixed for regular traders. Case in point, 40-year-old Machindra purchased 10,000 kgs of cabbage from a farmer in Nasik for 3 rupees per kilo, but sold it at 6 rupees per kilo at the APMC market.
Mandi mein kitna aamdani uske 6 rupees pe ka to paisa hota hai uska bhada aata hai 12000 rupees aur idhar ka kharcha hai 5000 rupees total mila ke 20-25000 rupees kharcha aata hai to 6 rupees pe ka to 2-3000 rupees bachega nahi bike to 10000 rupees jayega.
Wholesalers like Chandrashekhar, who bought tomatoes at 10 rupees a kilo and sell it at a much higher rate to vegetable markets.
Abhi main tomato liya hai aur main 10 rupees se liya hai. Abhi hum udhar jaake 3 rupees transport hai, 2 rupees hai, 1.5 rupees milega to kyunki usme wastage bhi bahut hota hai. Loose maal rehta hai na, tabhi wo fekna padta hai. Iske liye wo 15 rupees mein wo log hum log bechenge udhar.
We then followed the wholesalers to the local vegetable market where these tomatoes were then sold for between 16 and 20 rupees per kilo. This is now the second time that prices have changed.
Kande ka dam bahut hi kam ho raha hai abhi. Abhi hum market se 10 rupees kilo, 9 rupees kilo, 8 rupees kilo utha rahe. Lekin idhar abhi 20 rupees kilo, 15 rupees kilo bech rahe hum log.
और अगर टमाटर की बात करें तो वो मार्केट से कितने दाम में आपने उठा और यहाँ पे कितने दाम में?
टमाटर के रेट भी बहुत डाउन हो गए अभी मार्केट में. मार्केट में भी टमाटर अभी 8 रुपए किलो चल रहे हैं. इधर हम लोग 20 रुपीस किलो, 16 रुपीस किलो दे रहे हैं.
So, are farmers really getting the price they expect? The answer is a resounding no. The price they receive is at an all-time low.
5-6 रुपए अभी कांदे का रेट. अरे व्यापारी उधर 15 रुपए बेचता है अभी. हमको कुछ नहीं मिलता अभी कांदे में. अभी टमाटर का भाव 3-4 रुपए से हमको मिला 10 किलो का भाव, 3 रुपए किलो. और बाजार में जाता है तो 15 रुपए व्यापारी बेचता है. इसलिए ये जो फर्क है वो गवर्नमेंट ने कुछ तो करना मांगता है कि वो बाजार कांदे का कम आवा ज़्यादा भी नहीं मांगता. हम ही भाव उसको 15 रुपये मिलेगा तो भी हमको कांदा परोड़ता है.
Why is it that they get only about 10% of the money that you pay to your local vegetable vendor or convenience store? The answer, everyone makes a cut along the way except the farmer who grew it.
Maximum farmer doesn't bring that his own produce to market. They bring come into groups, small groups, then through middlemen, agents, and that's why we need a government support. Government should create a procurement center. They should purchase. They should keep some minimum assured price. And government should subsidize these vegetables, because without government's help, it is not possible.
What each farmer loses every time their produce goes from farm to plate. When Mirror Now did investigate on the ground, we saw that how there are different layers of pricing at different levels, right from the trader to the wholesaler to the retailer. At the end of the day, the consumer, and what farmer really gets is only this much, little amount of his own produce. This is the biggest challenge that the farmers are facing at this point in time. Especially for onions and tomatoes, the prices have crashed marginally, and that is what the farmers say have become unaffordable for them. Their only is at stake. With camera person Rajesh Khare, this is Disha Shah reporting here from Pune for Mirror Now.